On the contrary, you have a lot of say in how the office develops and you can join many different teams.
Although Wyman offers a variety of opportunities to get involved and shape things actively.
We have a lot of say. First of all, the events that are run and the social scene at the office, whether that's things like food in the kitchen or happy hour drinks.
But like, you can join the recruitment team, you can join the office events team, you can join a charity committee that we have. So in the office events team, we actually organize all social events at the Amsterdam office. So we do a mountain retreat, so we go away in the winter a couple of days, to a Christmas party, to dinners.
It's really about making work fun every day.
It doesn't become a lifestyle if you still have many, many other things to do throughout the week, such as sports, what I love to do.
Especially at the Amsterdam office, I think that work-life balance is very prioritized.
The good thing is about consulting and also over Wyman, you're given a lot of freedom to take control, even as a junior consultant. And I think it's about taking active control and, you know, knowing when to say no, this is too much.
Big part of talent management role is tracking the work-life balance situation on our project. We have different tools to monitor this. Whenever we see that there is not a healthy proportion between work and life for consultants, we have different tools and instruments of how to bring back the norm.
Well, I don't think it's really true.
Maybe it looks like that from the start. And once you're working for a little bit, then you realize that numbers are only the start. And it's much more about the story behind the numbers and what they actually mean for the business and for any strategy or advice that you give your clients.
My background, again, was part science, part arts. I would say I'm more of a creative person, though I do like numbers. And the kind of work that we get to do, while general problem solving, that's not to say it's fully numbers focused.
I mean, we do highly analytical projects, but we also do highly qualitative projects. And I would say that most projects are a mix of both. And even on the highly analytical projects, it would be a bit odd if we would only focus on numbers, because if we give the client a bunch of numbers, it's not going to say anything to them. So it's still part of your job to distill the key insights and write a compelling story on what the client should do with those insights.
I do think being comfortable with numbers is important. Our clients want to make well-informed, often fact-based decisions. And as a result, it's core to what we do. But in my opinion, the best analysis is worthless if it's not adopted or understood. So in my opinion, the key is to combine the analytical capabilities with your abilities to engage with others, to influence their opinion, to help them understand like complex issues.